Good morning, Warriors.
Welcome back to Warrior TV. I'm Riker.
And I'm Lizzie.
Getting right into it, the big October ACT test is coming. We are offering a prep class for $45 to any Weber High student who wants to improve their score or just prepare for the test.
This class is limited to 35 students, so act now. Pay the bookkeeper as soon as possible. You will get the official ACT prep book and 24 hours of instruction. Classes begin September 30th. Hey, Riker, do you like trivia?
Do I? Wait, do I?
Well, let's send it over to Caleb, Ryan, Danica with some trivia.
Hey, Warriors. Today, we're going out to ask you guys some trivia questions, and if you get the answer right, you get a free cookie. So, here we go.
I have to try?
Yeah. I'm going to ask you a serious question here.
Okay.
A serious question. What's the name of the teacher from a magic school bus?
Frizzle.
Give him a cookie.
Thank you.
If Josh has 5 waffles and he eats 2, how many does Caleb get?
None, because I get the rest.
What are the 3 branches of government?
Legislative, judicial, and executive.
Good job. Give him a cookie.
Yeah.
What is the oldest instrument to be found?
The drums?
False, it's the flute. What is the oldest instrument to be found?
The oldest? Oh, I don't know. The lute. I don't know.
Yes.
That's it for this week, Warriors. Look for us at lunch.
Seniors, if you've ever thought about becoming a Sterling Scholar, please go see Mrs. Blaisdell on room 506 to get more information. Applications are now being accepted. We've been told she doesn't bite.
Last week for homecoming, we had the chalk fight.
That was an interesting event.
Let's send it over to Hannah for some top-notch footage of that. For anyone interested in FBLA that missed the opening meeting, see Mr. Rollins for more information. The next meeting will be on Monday, September 30th at 7:50 a.m.
As we all know, homecoming was last week. Let's send it to Oakley, Naweed, George, Zach, and Daniel to see what people's favorite parts were.
Hi, my name is George Medina.
And I'm the amazing Naweed.
And today we're going to ask you what your favorite part about homecoming was.
What was your favorite part of homecoming?
I was late to my day, so I hit 110 on the freeway.
Probably all the plastic cups on the ground.
Bro, the dance for sure. It's fun. Man.
Going to Rush for my day. All of it! I liked all of it, but...
You know, just the atmosphere. It was great. We were dancing. It was crazy. Salt Lake was involved. It was fun.
Probably all the hype that has to go along with it. There's a lot of fun, excitement, activities that are along with it. I think it's good.
Wow, Warriors. That sounds like a great homecoming. Back to the anchors.
Juniors, it's time to register to take the PSAT. This test will prepare you for college entrance testing while offering the chance for scholarships.
This test only costs $35, but the benefit is worth much more. Please pay the bookkeeper no later than Friday, October 11th. Hey, do you know what time it is?
I'm not sure. What time is it?
It's time to send it over to the sports dudes.
How's it going, hooligans? I'm Connor.
And I'm Parker.
And together, we're the sports peeps with the cool Jeeps. First things first, Connor. How was your homecoming game?
It was radical. Weber took a fat dub against Layton, coming out with 48 points and Layton scoring 14 points.
Now let's send it over to Jerry and give him the spotlight and see what he asked Weber Warriors during the homecoming game.
What is good, Warriors? We're out here in the freaking crowd! Woo! And we're doing some interviews. We're here with Kate and we're gonna ask her what she thinks about the game so far.
You know, we're winning! And there's a pretty sunset, so... You know,
go. Good vibes.
We're live?
We're live.
Sounds good. We're here with Bree on the field. And it's just right after Bree, you won the home game. All right, what did you think of the games?
It was fun.
Yeah.
Oh, we started off a little slow, but then second drive, came out and kicked their ass.
What's good, Warrior TV? We're here with boy David. What did you think of the game, dude?
Everything I thought and more.
So, I didn't get to watch most of it, but for what I did watch, it was so good.
Cole Hogan, QB1. Literal, I can't say that. Amen.
Back to the sports, guys.
Looks like everyone had a great time this homecoming game.
Speaking of sporty activities, let's turn it over to Seth and Jason for a little HOCO recap.
Okay, Warriors, this week we're going to check out how the homecoming activities went. Bang, 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 we'll stop till we're legends.
Wow, homecoming looked amazing. There was so much fun stuff going on.
In other sports news, let's talk about the upcoming games next week.
On Monday, we have boys golf at Meadowbrook, which also extends to Tuesday as well.
Tuesday, we have girls soccer at Clearfield, and also girls volleyball at Weber.
Wednesday, we have cross country at Layton.
Thursday, we have girls soccer at Weber and volleyball at Davis.
And finally, we have a football against Davis at Weber at 7. Now in some Utah sports news, this week, both BYU and Utah lost their games.
Darn it, I really love watching both those teams getting the victory royale.
Oh, Warriors, as always, catch you on the spiral.
It's time to nominate a Weber High staff member for the PTSA Above and Beyond Award. It can be any staff that has made a difference in your education or in your life.
You can nominate a staff member by clicking the link on the PTSA page on the school site or by picking up a form in the main office.
Additionally, Hope Week starts next Monday, where we here at Weber recognize the value of life and work to preserve it. Let's send it over to Hannah, Alora, and Jackson to get some details.
Hey, Warriors.
With Hope Week right around the corner, we're going to go see what events we're up to.
Let's go!
On Monday from 5 to 7 p.m., Valley Elementary School is hosting food trucks, games, and live music.
On Tuesday from 4:30 to 6:30 at North Ogden Junior High, there will be suicide prevention awareness, food trucks, and games.
At Orion Junior High on Wednesday from 6 to 8 p.m., we're having a FAMX dance party and a pizza party. Epic!
At Weber High School on Thursday at 7 o'clock, Steve Starks will be presenting. Weber alumni will be there. Former president of the Utah Jazz and executive officer, board member of Larry H. Miller.
Friday, 7 p.m. at Weber High, there will be a football game. Students with two wristbands will be able to get in for free, and there will be prizes at halftime. Be there, Warriors. It's going to be awesome.
Believe.
Unite.
Defend.
Conquer. Back to the Acres.
The next attendance class will be September 30th through October 4th. This class takes off 0.75 and costs $20.
Don't wait till the last minute to make up your attendance. Please see Mrs. Knight in the office for a contract. I sure wish I knew what the weather was like outside today.
I just wish we had windows. But I know the next best way to figure out the weather. Let's send it over to Kenton with the weather for this week.
Knock, knock. Who's there? It's me, the Weather Queen. I'm Kenton Williams, and here's your weather for this week in Pleasant View, Utah. So, today there were a few clouds, so that's fun, not too bad. However, Saturday and Sunday, boom, storms. high of 55 and low of 45 on Saturday, and a high of 49 and low on 35 on Sunday. Getting shady, getting wet, and getting chilly in church. And there goes your weekend. But yippee, don't worry. The week is going to be mostly sunny, so it's still going to be cold though, so yeah, that's funny. Bundle yourself. Sending it back to the anchors.
Now that we've had the Chromebooks for several weeks, let's send it over to Will and Caleb to see what people think about them.
Gee, I sure do love my Chromebook. I love how my Chromebook has such long battery life.
Too bad you can't do anything with it.
And the Chromebooks are optimized for Google apps like Sheets and Google Docs.
But you still can't run any Adobe.
Man, I love how my Chromebook has such fast boot times.
There's actually nothing wrong with that. Good job, Chrome.
I love how lightweight and easy to carry my Chromebook is.
It was a lot better last year when we didn't have to carry him around anywhere.
I love how simple and effective the Chrome operating system is.
But you still can't play Minecraft!
Did you say something?
That's all the time we have for this week, Warriors.
Come back next week for more info.
Thanks for tuning in.